we've tried this and it's not working. Let's look not at different ways of thinking, mm-hmm. but complementary ways of thinking that might help us heal more rapidly. And of course, my focus is cell hydration has to be adequate for even the best of medicines to work. Mm-hmm. And that's why some individuals, you even put them on a saline drip, an IV drip, and they get better.
I've seen that. Yeah, I've seen
right?
that.
Mm-hmm. Because the solutions they were consuming, coffee, tea, soft drinks, mm-hmm. weren't doing the job. Yeah. Just getting them on a saline drip has shown remarkable improvements. So this is not that complicated, but it's so obvious it's been overlooked for a long time.
I'm totally grateful to you that you came and spent so much time with us today. And I hope we kind of put a little light on the importance of water. If you'd like to have more shows of this nature, you need to call us. And next time we're going to go to Colorado, and maybe we run into you there.
Very good.
And
good
so time. I really sort of thank you for coming, and you have a safe trip. And
great. Well, thank you very much.
Tell the wife we are very grateful
great.
That she chose this route in her spiritual evolution. And thank you very much.
Good. Well, thank you.
Okay. Bye-bye. Good evening. This is an exciting show we have planned for you today. When we came to the studio earlier, we realized we were speaking four languages. And that kind of sets up for what we want to do today. Today we will have a show with an interpreter. So if I don't get it exactly right, so just bear with me. One of the things I want to do is do some intercultural shows, as you know, and there has been requests. To refresh your memory, we had talked about the water that is shaped like snowflakes, the clustered water, as we called it. And we had sort of left you with a cliffhanger and said that we might get lucky and have Mr. Chung come and visit with us in Korean. And so today, if you don't understand parts of it, this is for the English viewers, please bear with us. We're going to speak more Korean today than we do English, so you just bear with us and we will make it as easy for you as we can. So I guess we will introduce our guests. Mr. Dean Chung, it is very nice to see you again.
네, 안녕하세요.
We spent a little time together 네. yesterday. Very nice to have you here, thank you. And of course you recognize Sharon Medal. Always want to call her Shannon, but she's nice enough to be our interpreter today. So maybe you would want to recap real quick in Korean what I said.
아, 오늘은요, 아, 이 미국 사람들보다 한국 여러분을 위해서 아, 이 쇼가 나가는 것이니까 아, 영어는 많이 안 하고 한국말로 많이 할 것이니까 아, 그리 이해하시라고 얘기했습니다.
Thank you. One of the things is we couldn't do the writing in the Korean language. So I'm going to put this down here. So what we found an ad in the paper that sort of deals with the subject that we talk about today. And that's for the friends that want to see it in writing.
Oh, you did find it, huh?
Mm-hmm. I ran into that at the grocery store.
You did? Oh, mm-hmm. Yes.
Wonderful, no?
Yeah. We did put it in the newspaper.
Mm-hmm. So welcome. And we had a couple of questions for you, if you don't mind.
Yeah.
I understand that you are native of Korea. And would you like to tell the friends how it happened that you came to America and as a result in Olympia, Washington?
You want me to say next?
You can just answer in Korean and then yeah. She can translate that.
Yeah. 에 제가 그 한국에서 미국에 온 지는 지금 21년째 돼가는 옛날에 왔어요. 그런데 많은 한국인들이 이 미국에 와서 겪는 것처럼 저도 사실은 공부를 하러 왔지만은 공부를 다 못하고 이제 생활전선에 뛰어드는 거예요. 그러면 이제 그 여러분들 다 아실 거예요. 한국 이민자들이 얼마나 힘들게 예, 사는지 저도 그 중에 하나입니다. 그래서 어떤 때는 하루에 15시간, 16시간까지도 일하는 때가 있었어요. 투잡, 쓰리잡을 했으니까. 그러다 보니까 몸이 조금씩 이상해져 가는 걸 저는 젊을 때는 몰랐었어요. 그런데 조금 지나니까 점점 구역질도 나오고 머리도 아프고 피곤하고 네, mm-hmm. 이런 일이 생기기 시작했어요.
Okay, so how far did we get?
Okay, now, what he's saying, mm-hmm. there was a 21 years ago mm-hmm. that he came to United States. Actually, he came here for education.
Mm-hmm.
But then, as you know, you needed money to have education. Mm-hmm. So he wind up working such a long, long hours. Mm-hmm. Plus, he's going to school. And therefore, later he realized he's not so healthy anymore. Mm-hmm. So his body started getting weaker and weaker. That's how far we went. So he's going to say why he was so weak.
Okay. 그래서 이제 그게 너무나 심해서 이제 지금 제가 잘 아는 옛날에 저희 교수님이신 그 닥터 정이라는 분한테 찾아가게 됐던 거죠. 그 당시는 이제 가서 보니까 이미 간에 지방이 많이 쌓여 있고 그다음에 여러 가지 그 증세가 나타나기 시작했죠. 존디스라든지 또는 노지아 같은 이게 구역질 난다든지 이런 게 나기 시작했어요. 얼굴은 노래지고 눈도 노래지고 좀 너무 피곤하고
Okay. Yeah, let me go up to there.
Okay, well, I'm nodding my head because I heard the story in English yesterday, so I can't find your questions. I know where you're at.
And the reason why he was so nauseated is because he went to Dr. Chung, he's a friend, and find out that he has a liver problem. Therefore, his face started getting yellow, and his eyes getting yellow, and then that's the reason why he was getting weak. Okay. Mm-hmm.
그런데 이제 그거를 이제 젊기 때문에 그냥 이겨내지 싶하고 내가 일만 좀 덜 하면 괜찮지 하고서는 그냥 말았던 거예요. 그래서 이제 그 심ptom이 너무 강해지니까 이제는 그 정사영 박사님을 다시 찾아가서 그분한테 어떻게 하면 이걸 낳을 수 있나 하니까 그분이 저는 약학하는 줄을 그분이 알고 있거든요. 그런데 네가 네 방법으로는 되진 않는다. 예, 우리 의사들 분야에서도 이건 참 어려운 너 같은 경우는 어려운 케이스다. 그러면서 저한테 어브라든지 그 다음에 베지터블 주스라든지 이런 거를 트라이 할 거를 저한테 권장했어요.
Okay. So he getting weaker and weaker, so he went back to check with the doctor again, and then doctor says what he was thought. Well, I'm so tired. I'm doing too much. So maybe I'll just loosen up a little bit. I don't work so hard. Maybe it will go away. But it didn't go away. And so he went to doctor again, and the doctor said your method is not going to work. And so you're just going to have to do something. So either you're going to take some medication or there's some herb or something you have to take care of yourself. Okay.
네. 네, 그래서 이제 그 어부를 택했지만은 그게 좀 나한테 조금 그 전에 했던 그 이런 다른 메디케이션보다는 그게 더 조금 나한테 받는 이 그 워킹하는 그런 걸 느꼈어요. 그렇지만은 그것 이제 그 조금씩 구역질 좀 덜 하고 좀 괜찮다 싶지만은 그래도 여전히 그 피곤이라든가 너무 심하고 그러다가 난데없이 머릿속에 마이그레인 헤드액이 굉장히 심해지기 시작했어요. 그래서 이제 정사영 박사님 다시 찾아가지고 왜 이러냐 그러니까 닥터 하나를 소개시켜 주면서 엑스레이를 찍어 봐라.
Okay, let's stop here. Okay. No, then it's getting worse and worse, but when he start treating with the some herb medicine, he feels a little better, but still he's throwing up and he's still having a problem, but then on top of that, he's having a different type of problem now. Mm-hmm. He's getting nauseating, he's getting headache, and then his head started hurting too. And so now that he has to go to a different doctor. Mm-hmm. Now let's see what he found out from him.
그런데 이제 그 닥터가 이제 그 진단 결과 뭔가 희미한 그런 게 뇌 속에 보인다. 그런데 그게 뭔지는 모르겠지만은 이거를 이제 바이옵시를 해야 자세히 알 수가 있다. 이렇게 얘기를 하는데 그때 나는 almost 그냥 샥 했었어요. 내 뇌 속에 뭔가 들어 있다는 것이 나한테는 너무너무 충격적인 일이 있었어요. 그래서는 또한 그 가장 더 충격적인 얘기는 그 사람이 지나가는 얘기를 했을지 모르지만 너 라이프 인슈런스가 있느냐 하고 물어봤을 때 나는 정말로 주저앉고 싶었어요.
Wow, okay.
That's insurance. That was insurance.
Now you understood that one.
Nice that one. Yeah.
Okay, so now he went to get another specialist. Mm-hmm. They just start taking X-rays, mm-hmm. and then they discover there was something in there like a tumor, mm-hmm. but they don't know what it is, but they have to get the X-rays and all that, but then meantime he asked, "Do you have a life insurance?" Mm-hmm. That just really, you know, almost fall down. You know, is a shock because that mean he was thinking maybe that is
life insurance.
Yeah.
그래서 바로 그 당시 나는 life insurance가 없었거든요. 근데 내가 죽는다고 생각하면은 우리 아이하고 우리 저 이 와이프는 어떻게 해요? 그래서 죽는다는 것보다는 먼저 그 생각이 더 들더라고요. 그래서는 바로 라이프 인슈런스 쪽으로 뛰어갔죠. 뛰어가서 나는 처음에는 100만 불짜리 하나를 들고 싶었는데 이거는 피지컬 테스트를 해야만 들어줄 수 있는 거예요. 그래서는 피지컬 테스트 없이 들을 수 있는 미니멈이 얼마나 그러니까 맥시멈이 20만 불 정도를 들을 수 있다고 해서 그걸 사인하고 왔어요.
Okay, let's go from there before I forget what all he said. Okay, now what he's saying is that right now what he wasn't worried about his sicknesses anymore, but what he was so concerned about his children, his family, his wife. So all he could think of, what if I die? But he has no insurance. So first thing he did, and he went to insurance the agent. He says, how much it'll cost to get $1 million?
$1 million.
Yeah, $1 million. And they said, well, you got to get a physical examination for the, that type of insurance, life insurance. So he said, well, what about the one? And you don't have to have a physical examination. They said, about $200,000.
Yeah.
So he, what did he do? What
yes,
did
he sign of his
oh, he signed then.
And
that's
then,
what
then
he
come
came.
Back home, and then I, the. 그래가지고 다시 이제 그 policy를 읽어봤어요. Mm-hmm. 읽어보니까 여기에는 6 months 이전에 critical disease가 이렇게 발견되면 insurance pay를 안 한대요.
Oh, now he found out. And so he signed for the $200,000. And then he came home and he reading the policy on that. He says if anybody had existed sicknesses, pre-existed for 6 months, hey, then it doesn't cover.
Yeah.
그래서 이제 다시는 닥터한테 안 가서 기록을 남기지 않으려고 다시는 안 갔어요.
Oh, I see. Now that after that he got scared. If he has a record, he couldn't have it even $200,000. So he never went back to doctor again.
It's so sad when we are put in a position like that. That you know we have to make a choice. You do or die, actually. So.
예, 그리고서는 이제 에, 나도 노력을 많이 했죠. 어떻게 하면 내가 살 수 있는가? 물론 막연한 그런 추측이지만 혹시 내가 나쁜 병이 걸리지 않았는가? 생명에 문제가 있는 병이 아닌가? 이래서 이때부터는 immune system에 관한 여러 가지 문서도 보고 논문도 보고 그런 업도 찾아다니고 하면서 그거를 공부를 시작했던 거예요. 아마 대학에서 내 공부 한 번 더 열심히 했어요. 대학에서는 내가 학점을 맡겨서 했지만은 이거는 내가 생명을 살리기 위해서 했으니까 참 열심히 공부해서 그런 약들을 찾아다녔던 거예요.
I see. He was studying very, very hard in a college because he will get the diploma. But at this time, after he found out what might be wrong, mm-hmm. he studied just about every kind of a similar situation as someone's, you know, to, in the books and then all the mm-hmm. records and recorded. He studied it so hard and tried to figure it out just how he could able to help himself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then something happened. Tell us what happened.
Yeah, 그래서
yeah,
이제
that changed your life.
에 그러다가 이제 그 여러 가지 그 이 immune system에 관한 그런 공부도 했고, 그다음에 그런 어부를 찾아다녀서 좀 찾기도 하고. 그래서 그러면서 이제 그 싸게 그거를 갖다가 내가 구입하기 위한 수단으로 이제 때에 따라서는 멤버십에도 가입하고, 때에 따라서는 그거를 좀 잠깐 세일스도 좀 하고 하는 그런 과정이 있었어요 저한테.
Order to get this, to find out, to get the cheapest way to treat it himself. He even joined some type of membership to order to get a wholesale. So he's studying it, all different types of way that he could have mm-hmm. to help himself with a natural way. That's mm-hmm. what he was hunting for, something that could help him natural way. Mm-hmm. That's where he is now.
그러다가 이제 우연히 이제 제 친구 하나가 아, 우리 로렌슨 박사가 이 물을 발명했는데 mm-hmm. 그 물이 여러 가지에 좋다는 얘기를 저한테 아주 열심히 해요. 하면서 그분이 세미나가 매달 며칠 날 있으니까 한번 프레젠트를 해라. 그래서 제가 그 세미나를 가게 됐죠.
Oh, then while he was searching for this something to help him, some his friend was mentioning that someone named Dr. Lorenzen discovered some clustered water that which could help you. Mm-hmm. It might help you, so why not look into? He says that he's going to have a seminar certain date. Why don't you go and listen to him? So he went. Mm-hmm. Then let's see what he found out.
예, 그 친구는 이제 일본 사람인데 사실은 그 친구가 이 클러스터 워터를 저보다 더 신봉을 해요. 그런데 제가 그때 이제 세미나에 가서 이 로렌슨 박사 얘기를 들어보니까 정말로 제가 모르던 어메이징 띵을 거기서 알게 됐어요. 그래서 그때부터는 열심히 저분한테 배우고 열심히 시작을 했죠. 그런데 이제 이 물을
okay, and he said that after he found out there was a Japanese friend mm-hmm. and introduced him, and he knows a lot more than he did. And then after he learned what the clustered water could do for him, he really tried to learn as much as he can from Dr. Lorenzen. Mm-hmm. So he learned more about it so he could help himself, his health wise. And so he's studying now, he's going to find out some more.
It is my understanding that Dr. Lorenzen, a lot of the literature, a lot of the books and things is in Japanese.
Yes.
So it was very fortunate that you had a Japanese friend that could read that, back to the different languages here.
그래서 이제 그때 말, 그 말이 맞습니다. Mm-hmm. 그래서 이제 책을 구해서 일본 말로 된 책이 아홉 권이 나와 있어요. Mm-hmm. 근데 그 책 하나를 구해서 읽고 또 저분한테 하면서 다시 또 먹기 시작했죠. 클러스터볼을 마시기 시작했는데 한 열흘 마셨나? 그런데 점점 게링 워스에 점점 몸이 더 나빠져요. 나빠지면서 더 하고 피곤하고 자꾸 어지럽고 그래서 이제 점점 침대에 눕게 됐어요. 그래서 일주일 동안 침대에 누웠어요. 근데 다른 사람 같으면은 거기서 끝냈을 거야 아마 안 하고.
Oh, isn't that interesting? And so they have written in the book 9 different books about the clustered
exactly.
water.
Mm-hmm.
And so he was studying all that. And then he started drinking this water because he was believing, hoping that it'll help him.
Mm-hmm.
And then he was drinking about 7 days.
Mm-hmm.
And then he getting worse and worse, and he just wind up in the bed. That's the way he got into it.
I know what that is. That's called a healing crisis.
Yeah.
And sometimes you
yeah.
have to be almost not here before you get better. So.
제가 그거를 알기 때문에
yeah.
그거를 스탑을 않고 오히려 저는 더 많이 마셨어요. 다른 사람한테 이렇게 절대 그러지 마세요. 하지만 저는 그거를 믿기 때문에 처음에는 에이드 원스를 아침에 한 그라스, 저녁에 한 그라스씩 먹다가 나중에는 almost 1갤런을 먹었어요.
하루에요?
예.
Yeah.
그래서 남들은 하지 마. 저는 그렇게 했어요.
You see, he was so sick, but yet he knew it'll help him. He was so convinced that it'll help him. And so even though he was so sicker than what it was, he wasn't scared. He just knew it would happen. So he started with the 8 ounce glass a day, and then it wind up with a 1 gallon a day. You see, nobody should do that, but he knew he was desperate, and he knew he will help him. So that's far he went.
예, 그러다가 이제 한 열흘 후에 어느 날 갑자기 주일날 아침에 일어나서 힘이 에너지가 나오고 걷기 시작하고 그때부터 몸이 아프지 않아요. 한 가지 두 가지 저는 사실은 예, 위장도 안 좋았고 장도 안 좋았고 그 다음에 이 브랑카이티스가 있었어요. 이 기관지염이 있었는데 그거는 이제 그 닥터들은 내가 안 갔지만은 그 기관지염까지도 전부 다 서서히 없어지는 거예요. 없어지면서 지금 여러분들이 보시다시피 저는 굉장히 건강합니다. 제가 지금 어떤 사람한테 미국 사람한테 물어보면은 저보고 40살이냐 어떤 사람은 39살이냐 이렇게 물어봐요.
그렇게 보이네요.
네, 지금은 그렇게 건강합니다.
Okay. You need to tell me what he said because let me say this in English first. Because simply because we're going to go into the actual water in a little while, and so then I sort of. Would like for you to translate.
Okay,
what he, said.
What he did is about 10 days later, mm-hmm. after the drink, start drinking the 1 gallon a day, and then one day he just got up. He just had the energy.
Mm-hmm.
He just didn't have all that symptoms, but he had it,
mm-hmm.
and so he felt so good. And then so after that, and then he not only had it tumor, so he hoping or something in the liver, not only that, digestive problem, that health, you know, all kinds of problem top of that. But he never went to doctor for that, but. After that thing, that time, he was energy, and he feels so good looking at himself. As people even said, "Are you only about 30-some years old? Who 40-some years old?" and things like that. So he feels real good.
Now, if for any reason you was to see Dr. Lorenzen today, what would you tell him?
Just say thank you. 아니 감사합니다. 밖에는 할 말이 없어요. 사실은 저분이 그분이 나 생명을 살린 거나 같으니까.
I understand he's a pretty incredible person. The friends up in Anchorage, you were familiar with him. He had just visited there. And so...
And he's saying that he's like, he's the one who gave him the life. So, you know, what could he say any more than just to thank you, he says.
Mm-hmm. So, well, let's see. What else we're going to do here? Very shortly, we're going to go into the water part of it. But anyway, I just wanted to say something else to the friends in Lansing, Michigan. What happens is that now that you have joined us and we're trying to introduce you to this wonderful stuff, so what you need to do is write me a letter. If you want more shows of that nature, then you go and do this. And wow, who have we here?
Oh, Dr. Lorenzen.
We have... You can tell him yourself. How are you? What a surprise. Anyway, I'd like to introduce you now to Dr. Lorenzen, our surprise guest. And maybe you would like to ask a question of your friend here that you think might be really important to share.
Well, first of all, 안녕하세요.
안녕하세요.
When I heard the story of Mr. Jung, I was really inspired because sometimes with new technologies, it's difficult for people to grasp the importance of these types of things. But Mr. Jung is a pharmacist, so he's been trained in the medical field, and he knew about medications. He knew a lot of these things. So fortunately, he wasn't biased by what he had learned, but he had the educational background to say, hey, I'm in a situation, what other complementary things can I be doing other than drug therapy to help me, you know, resolve this physiological issue? So the technology that we've developed has really been very helpful, but it really takes people with courage and with foresight to say, hey, I think this might help. Mm-hmm. And Mr. Jung has really been an inspiration to me because of what he's been through. And it was a love that he had for his family that motivated him to get well. And that's really inspiring to me. So I'm very happy to have him as a close friend.
You mean he's a doctor too then?
He's a pharmacist. Yes.
Yeah, we're going to ask you about your background here in just a minute too, but can you translate this in Korean, please?
I think he can tell better than I can.
Would you be nice enough to read?
You can tell.
Okay. Either one, just fine.
My English is more, you know.
No, Korean.
And 한국말로요. 얘기를 해달라는 거예요.
글쎄요, 이제 여러분들 다 이해를 하셨겠지만 이분이 얘기하는 것은 이 미스터 정을 만나가지고 미스터 정한테 여러 가지 좋은 인상을 받았고 미스터 정이 또 이 물에 대한 이 테크놀로지를 깊이 이해해서 여기에 인볼브하는 그것을 많이 도움을 받았다고 또 이런 얘기입니다. 뭐 또 자세히 저도 사실은 자세히.
Dr. Lorenzen 얘기하시는 것은 자기가 도운 것보다도 그 Dr. Jung이 많은 도움을 받고 이렇게 건강하게 사시니까 자기도 기쁘다는 것입니다. 자기가 만드는 이런 좋은 그 진동수 물로서 도움을 받았다는 걸 볼 때에는 얼마나 그게 기쁘시겠어요. 그 아픈 사람을 자기가 그 만든 물건을 가지고 도와줬다니 그렇다 보면 다른 사람에게도 큰 도움이 된다는 일이죠.
네, 우리 집안 식구들은 전부 로렌슨 박사한테 그냥 항상 고맙다고 그래요.
그렇죠. 생명을 살려주셨는데요.
저희 집도 아니 저뿐만 아니라